Hello. Next solved problem in the topic projectile motion. This is the problem. The trajectory of a projectile near the surface of the earth is given as y is equal to 2x minus 9x square. If it were launched at an angle theta naught with speed v naught, then take g as 10 meter per second squared. Option A, theta naught is equal to sine inverse of 1 by root 5 and v naught is equal to 5 by 3 meter per second. Option B, theta naught is equal to cos inverse of 2 by root 5 and v naught is equal to 3 by 5 meter per second. Option C, theta naught is equal to cos inverse 1 by root 5 and v naught is equal to 5 by 3 meter per second. Option D, theta naught is equal to sin inverse 2 by root 5 and v naught is equal to 3 by 5 meter per second. This question was asked in JEE main 2019 in one of the papers. Is it clear? Now we'll go to the solution side. We know that equation of motion of projectile is y is equal to x tan alpha minus gx squared by 2 v naught squared cos square alpha. In this, alpha is angle of projection, x is x coordinate of any point, y is y coordinate of any point. Here alpha is theta naught, because in the question theta naught is given, but the equation I have used alpha just for my convenience. So alpha, whenever I say alpha, it means theta naught as per the question. This is the equation of motion of projectile. Is it clear? But the given equation is y is equal to 2x minus 9x squared. You see, there is a very good comparison between the two, x and x, x square and x square. So you can easily compare and sort out things. Comparing the above two equations, here x, so tan alpha is equal to 2, and here x square, so leave that. The remaining thing, g by 2 v naught square cos square alpha would be 9. That's what is given here. So you already know, you already found here the value of tan alpha as 2. Is it clear? From that you can you just keep it, we will use it at a later stage. Okay, now you construct a triangle, right triangle. Because tan alpha is equal to 2, you know, so you mark it, you mark this as alpha, then you may take it as 2x, take it as x. So that tan alpha will be 2x by x is equal to 2. See, this is better this way, rather than taking BC as just 2 and AB as just 1, it is better to take as 2x and x. Okay, so you can easily get AC using Pythagoras theorem. Why should you take this as 2x and x? Because tan alpha is equal to 2. We want to get other trigonometric ratios. So you construct the right triangle ABC. In that you mark this as angle, this angle as alpha, this should be 2x, this should be x. So the tan alpha is 2x by x, which is 2. So you can find the hypotenuse by Pythagoras theorem. AC is equal to root of x square plus 2x square, which is root of x square plus 4x square, simplify x into root 5. From this you can find sin alpha, cos alpha. Okay, tan alpha we found straight away from the equation. You can find sin alpha and cos alpha from this triangle. You get sin alpha 2x by x by root 5, which is 2 by root 5. Again cos alpha x by x root 5, which is 1 by root 5. So you see that tan alpha we got from the comparison between the equations, sin alpha and cos alpha from the triangle, all the three ratios. Because you keep them, when you want to finalize on the solution, we will see which is to be used. Okay, then also from this, g by 2 v naught square cos square alpha is 9. We want to find v naught also, right? So v naught is equal to 9 will come to this side, but g is given as 10. So 10 by 2 into 9, which is 18, cos square alpha, because you know cos alpha 1 by root 5, cos square alpha 1 by 5, which will be, this 5 will go to the numerator, 50 by 18, simplify by 2, cancel by 2, 50 by 2, 25, 18 by 2, 19. So 25 by 9. Therefore, this is V naught square. So V naught will be square root of 25 by 9, which is 5 by 3 meter per second. So we have got sine alpha 2 by 1 root 5, cos alpha 1 by root 5, V naught value 5 by 3. Therefore, the correct option is C. Is it clear? That is, you see in C, you have got theta naught cos inverse 1 by root 5 and V naught 5 by 3 meter per second. Is it clear? Then we have a discussion about this problem, which will be very useful in different problems on projectile motion. See, slope of the line at x equal to 0 will give you tan alpha. If you draw the graph of the parabola y is equal to 2x minus 19, here y is equal to 2x minus 9x square, but here alpha theta naught, because use tan alpha is set, no, alpha is theta naught, don't forget this. This is the graph of the given equation. Given equation is y is equal to 2x minus 9x square, which is the equation of a parabola. So this will be that. This is y axis, this is x axis. This is the alpha value. Now you take it as a graph. So y is 2x minus 9x square. So differentiate. Dy by dx will be 2 minus 18x. At x equal to 0, when you have to put x 0 here, so this will become 0, dy by dx will be 2. That is nothing but tan alpha. We also already got tan alpha as 2. Here also you are getting tan alpha as 2. Okay, this is the extra discussion, so that you will get to know the subject more and more thoroughly, right? So the given equation, that is this one, can be rearranged like this. Take 2x outside, you will get 1 minus 9x by 2. That is this equation also available for the projectile motion. Y is equal to x tan alpha into 1 minus x by r. Now compare this and this. 2x, x tan alpha. Tan alpha is 2, we already proved. 1, x and x. Minus symbol, minus symbol. 9 by 2 should be 1 by r, so r should be 2 by 9. It is in meter because you are asked to take g as 10 meter per second squared. So obviously all the corresponding quantities will be in SI. Okay, this is to find the range in case if they ask. This problem he has not asked in case. Okay, then how to find the maximum height? Putting x is r by 2 in this equation. Because the coordinate of the highest point, x coordinate will be r by 2. This is what 2 by 9 means, it will be 1 by 9. Because the curve will be symmetric about this line. Okay, so total is r means this will be r by 2. This will be another r by 2. So putting x is equal to r by 2 in the given equation, r by 2 is 1 by 9. Y is equal to 2x minus 9x square. This is 2 by 9, this is 9 by 81. 81 you take as LCM. Then you will get 18 minus 9 by 81, 1 by 9. So maximum height will be 1 by 9. Of course, that also will be in meters. See, these things are not required for solving the problem. As I already told you, we will try to absorb or extract more information from the problem so that it will be useful elsewhere in a corresponding situation, in a similar situation. Okay, so now that we know V naught and theta naught, we found V naught already, theta naught already, we can find time of flight by using the corresponding formula 2u by 2u sin alpha by g is the time of flight. Here it will be 2V naught sin theta naught by g will be the formula for time of flight, but here not asked. You want to try, you can try using the corresponding formula for time of flight. Okay, please like, subscribe and put your comments so that I can clear any doubts, or I can give the reply to your comments. Thank you.